Are you asking about lighting?
Yes.
What light would you like, Mum?
No, I don't. I don't come into it because you're the lighting director in this circumstance.
How do you think you would have been if you were a Hollywood star? Would you have been demanding and difficult?
Yeah.
Would you?
Undoubtedly.
Would you?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. That's a good job you weren't then, isn't it?
Yeah, isn't it?
Yeah. If I was to say Citizen Kane, does that mean anything to you?
Yeah, of course.
Do you like it?
Yes. Greatest film ever made, as they say sometimes.
Well, it usually ends up at the top of most people's best films of all time. And I have to confess, it was probably one of the most innovative...
Yeah, for its time.
For its time, innovative films, made. If I was to say David Fincher, director of Gone Girl, whatever the one about Facebook is.
Zodiac.
He did Zodiac. He did Fight Club.
Fight Club.
He did The Game. All those kinds of things.
Yeah.
He's quite a classy director, though I have to say me and Nadia actively walked out of Gone Girl. We couldn't stand it.
No, I never saw Gone Girl, so I don't know.
So that's David Fincher. So we've done David Fincher, Citizen Kane. Are you an Orson Welles fan?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, what about Gary Oldman?
Yeah, I don't know about Gary Oldman. I mean, I think he's always been excellent in everything I've seen him in, but I don't think I've seen him in as much stuff as most
people. What did you think of him in the Churchill film?
I liked him
Darkest Hour.
I liked him a lot, but previously, by only about 3 weeks, I'd seen Brian Cox doing Churchill and thought he was better.
Oh.
Funnily enough.
Oh, right. Yeah. Oh, okay. I suppose Gary Oldman, for me, he's part of that old school, a bit like whatever the name of the big guy is who was in Sexy Beast. What's his name?
Ray Winston.
He's sort of, I always think of him in the same breath as him. He's sort of that old school, so he's kind of reliable, but... he always sort of plays the same part.
He does.
Doesn't he?
Yeah, yeah.
He was a good villain in the Batman films. Okay, well, I'm beating around the bush here. This is a film called Mank. It's a
Mankiewicz.
Yeah, Herman J. Mankiewicz.
Yes.
Who was the co-scriptwriter of Citizen Kane.
Oh.
It's a story about him. So this is a movie about the movie business.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Maddie saw the teaser for it.
Okay.
It's hotly sort of tipped to be probably Netflix's major contestant for the Oscar. It's all black and white. A little bit of Roma going on there, but obviously not like Roma as far as it's not Mexican. it's a portrait of Herman J. Mankiewicz's life. Well, the making of Citizen Kane, but it's about his alcoholism.
Okay.
Within the Hollywood system. Mank.
They really should have called it something else.
Sounds a bit like...
Well, we know what it sounds like, but also it's like... It would just... If I saw that...
Title.
I knew nothing else. I just wouldn't.
Would you?
I wouldn't go.
Oh, right. Okay. Well, there you go. Apparently, that was his nickname on set.
Well, I'm sure it was, but you could give us a clue.
Yeah, maybe call it so. Anyway, as I say, me and Maddie watched the teaser. I don't know if you saw our reaction to the teaser.
No.
And within it, they've clearly riffed on all of the way in which Citizen Kane was shot.
Okay.
The cinematographer on Citizen Kane, Greg Toland, was a huge innovator of lenses.
Yeah.
Telephoto lenses, wide-angle lenses.
Ceilings. I mean,
breaking down sets and everything. Yeah. And they innovated on set. Orson Welles would walk onto set and he'd say things like, I need the lens to show me this, this, this. And the whole technical crew would go off and go, Jesus H. Christ, how are we going to do this? And they'd work it out. And sometimes, you're right, it would involve them collapsing sets or blowing the ceilings really high.
Yeah.
But anyway, the teaser almost emulated shot for shot all the key moments in Citizen Kane. So it'll be interesting to see how this plays. This is the full trailer. So it's not a teaser. This is the full trailer.
Okay.
For Mank.
Okay, for Mank.
It's Orson Welles.
Of course it is.
I think it's time we talk.
What is it the writer says? Tell the story you know.
Hello, everyone.
Make yourself to home, Mr. Mankiewicz, or shall I call you Herman?
Please, call me Mank.
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 This is Herman Mankiewicz, but where to call him Mank?
Mankiewicz.
That's why it's called Mank.
Mankiewicz, New York playwright and drama critic, and humble screenwriter, Mr. Hurst. This is a business where the buyer gets nothing for his money but a memory. What he bought still belongs to the man who sold it. That's the real magic of the movies.
Thunder,
lightning, blood, fire, religion.
Help! Someone save me!
All in one film. That's director proof.
That's why I always want Mank around.
I hear you're hunting dangerous game.
God bless William Randolph Hearst.
Ready and willing to hunt the great white whale?
Just call me Ahab.
Do come in.
At this rate, you will never finish.
You said 90 days. Well, said 60. I'm doing the best I can.
I've put up with your suicidal drinking, your compulsive gambling, your silly platonic affairs. You owe me, Herman.
Ooh, who do you think you are? You're nothing but a court jester.
What I want to know is what you think of it.
It's a bit of a jumble. The collection of fragments that leap around in time like Mexican jumping beans.
Welcome to my mind, Sock.
Him, I get. But what did Marion ever do to deserve
it's
this?
It's not her. Not all characters are headliners. Some are secondary.
You pick a fight with Willie. You are finished. Mayor can't save you. Nobody can. Especially the boy genius from New York.
I removed any distraction. Eliminated every excuse. Your family, your cronies, liquor. I gave you a second chance.
You cannot capture a man's entire life in 2 hours. All you can hope is to leave the impression of one.
Why Hurst? Outside his own blonde Betty Boop, you're always his favorite dinner partner.
Are you familiar with the parable of the organ grinder's monkey?
Whoa. So, it was Tom Burke.
So what are your thoughts?
It looks stunning.
It looks phenomenal.
It looks so stunning that it almost, if nothing else about it is good, I'd sit in the cinema and watch that.
Yeah,
over
I mean,
and over again.
Yeah, it's almost like regardless of how compelling the story is, yeah. And obviously they're trying to draw a parallel between the story of Citizen Kane and the story yeah. of Orson Welles and William Randolph Hearst being the huge, yeah. you know, media yeah. Yeah. magnate who was, you know, again at the sort of heart of Citizen Kane.
Yeah,
I think it's based on a screenplay, I think, by David Fincher's father.
Okay.
And yeah, I mean, I think it looks beautiful.
Stunning.
It could be, there's a danger, it could be style over substance.
Well, that's very possible.
Some of the details that they're riffing on there that I love as a film sort of historian lover mm-hmm. is that echoey sound of the time is exactly the voice
yes.
of the characters in Citizen Kane, and right yeah. down to the glass, we've said before, the glass falling out of his
yeah.
hand. It's the
yeah.
moment of the rosebud, you know, falling away.
Yeah. The lushness of it.
Yeah.
The, I don't know, it's sort of...
Rich.
Rich, but also like severe, but then also not severe. Yeah. I mean, it's just stunning.
But within it, you can see that clearly a portrait of a major alcoholic
oh,
narrative.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely,
do you think that was
yeah.
Gary Oldman's genuine Dulocs? Dulocs? What are they called? Dulocs?
They're called
sort of saggy bits.
Dulocs. I was just saying that I feel it's even better the fact that it's an homage to a great film and a great director and, you know, all the things that Orson Welles was. In a style that we wouldn't necessarily think of as Fincher.
No. I mean, he's kind of gothic horror, doesn't he?
Yeah, and he makes lots of different styles, I suppose, yeah. in a way. But you wouldn't sort of put him... You wouldn't automatically think of him for that, would
no,
you?
No, exactly.
So and, in that respect, no, good on him.
Yeah, yeah. I just hope it doesn't sort of, it's not slavishly sort of following the style and not giving us a really gritty story.
Yeah.
Because what you don't want is everyone acting in a sort of semi-plummy way. You want to be able to reach into the truth of them. And the danger with that era is that, yeah, whilst that's what people were like in films, I'm yeah. sure in real life, I know Orson Welles wasn't like that in real life, you know, and because they're going for that sort of plummy kind of, very on-screen sort of look and feel. I hope we don't lose the gritty, granular drama.
No, I don't think we will.
No, I don't think we will.
For more film and family fun, don't forget to click the subscribe button and make sure to click the bell to never miss an update.